Today we are going to make this yummy and creamy three-layered ice cream cake or mousse cake. So let's start making it. Before starting the recipe, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do it and also click on the bell icon for the further notifications. So first, let's grease our springform cake mold. A little bit oil or butter. So I've used melted butter. And then we are going to place the butter paper. I've used springform cake mold of circle shape. You can use of any shapes. Springform cake mold actually loosens the mousse cake or ice cream cake from the mold and its edges. So I am going to grease it again from the top. So it might need more butter because the cake is sticky, so it'll need more butter to loosen up. It'll help it to loose. So it'll actually help to leave the edges of the mold. Now we will also grease the edges very, very nicely because you know the cake will otherwise stick to the edges, and we need not get a messy cake if we do it. So I am greasing the edges very, very well. We need not get less butter or more butter. We are going to use the quantity like we think the cream will not stick to the edges. We'll use that much butter. So yeah, you can see I've used the springform cake mold. I'll show you, it opens like this and then close. So it helps like the plate from the bottom get loosens up, so we can just use it, take out our ice cream cake. So here I am using a bowl and a spatula. So here I had Oreo biscuits, and we are going to make the base with the Oreo biscuits. You can also use chocolate sponge cake. Don't use normal one, use a sponge cake. So I had a new one, it was hashtag stayed with Oreo, in which if you would be lucky, you would be getting a smiley Oreo, if you would be lucky, right? So I'm gonna see if I'll get a smiley Oreo or not. Side by side, I'm breaking them and putting in the mixer grinder jar. I'm really excited. Yeah, I have a challenge for you too. If I get the lucky biscuit, you need to like this video. I need a lot of likes on this video, right? So here I'm taking the first. Oh, the first biscuit is of the smiley, and I got the lucky biscuit, right? Now you need to like my video. Yay! Now we're gonna break it and put it in the mixer grinder jar. And now I'm gonna get alphabets. So the front biscuit is the normal base Oreo, and the second biscuit is of the alphabet or the lucky biscuit. You can also buy this, actually this is available everywhere. My dad ordered it from Amazon because here Oreos were not available, actually, because many of us just take Oreos in the option of biscuits, right? So that's when my father ordered it, and it was really nice. So I told my father to order it because I wanted to eat it and even taste it. Like, the taste was a bit more sweeter than normal biscuits. Yeah, so I'm breaking it with the cream only. Don't separate the cream, it will give that creamy texture kind of thing. So grind it. Yeah, so I got one lucky biscuit. You need to like the video now, huh? So let's grind it. Yeah, so my biscuits are ground to fine powder. Now we are going to transfer it into a bowl. So after transferring, I'm going to break it with a spatula because the cream's moisture might make lumps. And now check with your hands if there are any lumps of the biscuits. Just go and grind it again because the lumps will come and it will not combine up with the melted butter. So that's why I used my hands to check. Now I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of the melted butter. Yeah, I forgot to tell you the quantity of the Oreo biscuits. I actually use 4 packets of small Oreo biscuits. If you're like having big packets of Oreo biscuits, use like 1 packet of it contains 13 Oreo biscuits, so you can like count and get 20. So you need to use it between 16 to 20 cookies. So 2 tablespoon butter, melted butter. So mix it well. It should be like wet sand consistency. Now I'm taking my mold and you're gonna put the mixture in it. Now spread it evenly. It should be totally flat for clean edges when we take out the cake from our mold. So we're gonna spread it very very well with the spoon or a spatula or an like icing mold an icing spoon, right? So you can use that also. I'm using the spoon because you can see how easy it makes to do it. Again, my hands, my palm, my fist, my fingertips, and again the spoon. Take your time and spread it. I'm cleaning the edges and making it even from the edges too. Now we'll keep it in the fridge. Not the freezer, right? Not the freezer, in the fridge. For 5 to 10 minutes until we make the second layer. So here I have taken Mordei's dark chocolate compound, 1/2 cup of chopped Mordei's dark chocolate compound. So here I've kept it, and we're gonna add 2 tablespoons of milk in it. Warm or room temperature milk, don't use cold milk. I have used warm milk because it was just kept for boiling and it was a bit cool down and was warm, so I used it. Don't use hot milk or don't use cold milk, right? We need to use warm or normal milk. So actually, if you want like to grate the chocolate, you can even grate it, but it will actually take more time because the grating thing like leads to small like bits of chocolate. And if you chop it, I have chopped it, right? If you need to chop it, chop it when it's really cold, because these days it's really hot over here. And if you like use it when it's a bit warm or it's of room temperature, it'll just melt all over and you will not able to grate or chop it. Use cold chocolate. I actually chopped it yesterday and kept it in the freezer. Before chopping, it was kept in the fridge. So I'm using double boiler method with hot water, not boiling water. Hot water should be there, and we have to melt the chocolate very very well, so it's without the lumps and it's shiny. So we have made the ganache. We are making the ganache actually. So if you want to make a chocolate ganache or white chocolate ganache, you can also make it like this for decorating your cakes and all. So melt and mix it very very well. It would be a bit messy, like I have done it messy on my slab actually. So I'm not using a spatula now. So I've shifted here to a whisk. You can see how shiny it is without any lumps. This is called a ganache, but let it cool down on room temperature. Don't keep it in the fridge. Let it cool down on room temperature because we have to add in the whipped cream, and the cream might melt and the result will not be good. So here I have used like halfly whipped cream, not fully whipped, halfly whipped cream, and my ganache is cooled down. Now we are going to put the ganache in the cream. Yeah, again I tell you, please use room temperature, like the ganache should be at room temperature. And my cream is super chilled. I just bought it yesterday and I kept it in the freezer for overnight, and then when I woke up before making it, I kept it in the fridge, and then on an ice bed I whipped it. So we are going to mix it. Well, you can see how liquidy the cream is. It's a little bit thick than it comes in the carton or the bottle. I'm going to whisk it again to make it a little bit creamy. You can say a little bit thick to produce air in it. So I'm just whisking it with my hands. You can even use electric beater, but it will actually thicken the cream. If you want like the moussey kind of thing, a creamy thing, so you can whip it with the electric beater. Now, after 10 to 15 minutes, our Oreo base is ready and we are going to put the chocolate cream or the second cream base, or you can say the second layer of the cake on it, and we're going to spread it well. Actually, we are just making another layer of the cake, and then we are going to put another layer of the white chocolate mousse, you can say. If you don't have the spring form cake mold, you can even make that like we get it in coffee day, CCD, cafe coffee day, in small glasses. They just actually put a little bit of the cream and then a little bit of the cake and then all. So we're gonna keep it in the freezer for 10 to 15 minutes. Freezer, not the fridge. Now add 2 tablespoons milk in white chocolate compound. Then melt it. I have listened that actually white chocolate compound takes a bit more time than dark chocolate compound. But in my case, actually the white chocolate compound took less time than the dark chocolate compound. So I don't know why. Actually, yesterday when I was chopping the chocolate, even white chocolate was like melting all over, and the dark chocolate wasn't. Even I kept it in the freezer for a time. So yeah, you can see it's shiny and just like melt made. So whisk it a bit, melt all the lumps, and now our ganache, white chocolate ganache, is also ready. Decorate your cakes with it if you want to. Yeah, we are making. Yeah, so you can see I have thick cream here, not properly stiff, but it's thick than the white dark chocolate cake one, because it's the first layer or the top layer of the cake. It needs to be thick a bit. Like you can use stiff here or like more than halfly whipped cream, like 3/4 whipped cream. Now add the ganache. You have to add it very, very fast, because might be the cream is cold and it will again melt all over, or the chocolate can also freeze in it. So I whipped it and kept it in the freezer for it to thicken. You can see it's like melting all over, but it's okay. The consistency is perfect again, and we have to keep it on the freezed layer of chocolate. So it's the third layer, the topmost layer of the mousse cake. You might be thinking, why I'm calling it a mousse cake again and again? Because an ice cream contains milk made with cream and a little bit of cookies, or like this only it's made, but actually we're using the cream only over here. So that's why I'm calling a mousse cake, because only cream leads to mousse cake, and when we see mousse cake, it's just with the cream, right? Actually it's thinner than the mousse cake, but I call it a mousse cake. You can call it anything you want to. You can even call it trio or triple layer cake. So take out all the cream, don't waste it. Now spread it well. Take your time and spread it. digits should be there. Spread it well. You can see how creamy it is. I actually love this mousse cake because, again, the cream. Right, so this is done, and now I've cleaned the edges with the tissue cleaner cuts. Now cover it for no ice flaking and keep it in the freezer for about 2 to 3 hours or until it sets. Now you can see it's set, and I'm gonna open my mold. Wow, you can see how clean it came. I know the edges are a bit uneven, but when you will like clean it all up, it would be superb. Now I cut out some hearts out of baking paper or the butter paper, and I'm gonna place it on the mousse cake. Now I've taken the small sieve from which we sieve the tea, and I've added cocoa powder in it, and we're gonna sieve it. I have actually put the hearts for design when we take out the hearts from the, yeah, now you can see the design is there of the hearts. Three beautiful hearts on our cake. I am placing sugar silver balls on my cake for decoration. Now I made a bit designs with the butter knife for like a bit more beauty, and then again place the sugar balls, and I'm gonna cut. After every cut, dip your knife in hot water, not hot, warm water, right, for cleaner cuts and no merging of the creams when you see the edges of it. You can see our yummy and creamy mousse cake or ice cream cake is ready. Super yummy, super delicious. Do try it, just for beginners, right? Actually, I am a beginner of cooking. Do like my video, share the video, and comment your feedback about this yummy mousse cake. Yeah, I love it, and might be you also. So subscribe to my channel, click the bell icon, and enjoy.